Very warm welcome, Monday. Good evening. It is Legit Hustlers here on Urban TV with me, Brenda Kembabazi. Now, today we bring you Mr. Godfrey Nwagawa, the director of Universal High School here in Kisasi, who has a very great story. From earning 2,700 shillings, he's now a director and proprietor of a secondary school. So join me as we get into his story of how he started and where he is today. The viewers here would like to know who Mr. Godfrey Nwagawa is in a nutshell.
In a nutshell, I'm a professional teacher who studied in the far rural areas of Rukunjirwe Young Primary School, Tumbara High School, then to Makobore Erevo, finished Makere University in 1997, and taught in various schools in Kampala, including Chita, Antena, Kasero, up to Nandere Ruwero, where he was later posted to Nsanji SS as a headmaster, as a deputy headmaster, where I stayed for about 3 years. Then I had to think of starting Universal.
How did you think of leaving employment into actually starting something of your own?
Anyway, I may say, by nature, I was a businessman. I had a feeling that by hook or crook I must do business. Because even after senior four, I had some small shop in my small town in Buyanja. After senior six, I had a small shop. But when results came out and said you were supposed to go to Makerere government, I had to abandon the shop, bank the money. And after Makerere, I went into teaching in Kampala. Other friends of mine were looking for greener pastures in South Africa, where, but me, I said I don't need a passport. I need to remain here. I know Uganda is virgin. I'll get money. And that's how I joined teaching as my profession. I went to Chita until secondary school. Madame Kerije gave me a vacancy. I taught. I could get some other side businesses because the side was too small, as small as 2,700 shillings. Yet my rent was 4,000, so that's how I compare that earning and the economic situation at that time. I owned a shop in Chifumbra. I opened a store of beer in Kamu and Chamein. I opened a store of bread. Could go in Hot Loaf, pick bread, dump there, go tip-top, get beers, put in the store. Then these young boys, I put them there with bicycles, they distribute. Afternoon, at 1, I would make sure that by 1 I'm at Chita and teaching. Around 5-6 I would come back to the business, pick some money from customers, organize for the second day. And that's how somehow I managed to mobilize capital. And when I mobilized capital, then I thought of a bigger business. But definitely a bigger business, I had to look at my own qualifications. I like teaching. I said I must do business in my own profession. That's why I could not even think of a primary school, but I thought first of a secondary school where I was a qualified teacher and where I had experience. Then I started looking around for possibly which place can I hire. When I got a place, then the money was not enough even to raise the rent. But somehow a good Samaritan gave me a room at an institute on Saporo Kagwa, on Mwanga 2 Road, Mengo Chisei. And I started mobilizing some students. I remember one evening, a certain student brought just 50,000 shillings as school fees. I didn't have even a receipt book. And what I did was to write on a headed paper and sign and tell the student, take to your parent, tell him that you've reached school with this money. The following morning, I went to NASA Road, printed T-shirts, and put a very big label, Universal High School. Universal Academy. It started called Universal Academy in Mengo Chisenyi.
Started as Universal Academy.
Universal Academy. So I started even using the students of the institute to dress them up, those t-shirts, do that. Then I made sure that I improved the mobilization skills. In a short time, I found I had some about 40 students of A-level. We started with A-level.
So as Inverse Academy?
Inverse Academy. Then the hurdle comes in for registering these students for senior six. Mm-hmm. I take them as far deep in the Rukunjiri, near Teacher Secondary School.
For them to be able to sit for their exam?
To be able to sit in there. Because the Kampala schools were difficult to approach. Then the second year, we took them to Ruwero for registration also. Third year, we put them at Hamadia, and people passed. After that passing, most students started coming. We found we could not fit in the space. We had to hire on Sapor Kabua Road a bigger space. We changed the school from Universal Academy to Universal Trust Academy. Because I think we put in that trust for a reason. Because we felt now we are an entity that was now being trusted by parents. And by the time, by the end of 1996, we had over 400 students. That's why we managed to get money and buy the present site in Kisasi.
Okay, but just to take you a bit behind, when you had the 40 students, how did you liaise to get teachers that were actually teaching those students when it was still Universal Academy?
To me, that was simple because I was a professional teacher and I had a long-standing experience in the teaching profession in Kampala schools. There are some teachers who are like at Mengo, like at Makere College School, like at, you could go and fish for one for economics. You fish for another one from Mengo, it becomes a part-time. You fish another one from Murawaga, it teaches for you math. And at the end of the day, the students would feel they have the right teachers they need. And there they settled and would find they are really comfortable.
So at what point did you actually register the school for the students to be able to sit for their exams in the same school?
Okay, not only registering for students to sit in their own school, but even registering the institution itself was a hurdle. Because by that time, the ministry looked at us as rebels.
Because you were against the government schools.
I remember Sapporo, there is one time when my deputy was phoned in office and bundled to KCC court. And he had to sleep there for a day until we had to get approachment and a letter to get him from Ruzira and put him in court again to release him. So you can see registering the school itself was not easy, but we had to approach some good friends in the ministry. They gave us a license, a working license. We had to befriend the LOCs to give us recommendations, and then we formalized the registration, registering the school. And then registering the candidates themselves for UCCA and UACCA. It was also a tug of war because we didn't have a center. We got a center when we reached Kisasi after establishing good buildings. But at the beginning, as I said, the first lot, we had to take them to Rukunjiri, near Teacher Secondary School. The second lot, we had to take them in Ruwero. Then the third batch, we had to take it to Amadia. And then when Amadia started registering us, I think by fourth year, UNEB gave us a center. Just we had already constructed our first big building, our main building in Sasa, and we made a provision for a hall, which was a major requirement. And UNEB came and visited us, they approved the center, we started sitting our own candidates.
Okay, so now you had gotten a center number, you had had more students.
Tell us
how you actually managed to grow this school to where it is today.
We didn't have funding, but there was a bit of trust. We started with the Greenland Bank. He could give us a loan of 1 million, we pay it back, we put the building halfway. We go back, they give us 2 million, put the building halfway. We didn't and close it and we started with Centenary. I think Centenary Bank has not disappointed us every year. We usually have a small loan of Saint Anthony Bank, and we clear it. We don't go in for too much, and we don't go to different banks. No, we just get stuck to Saint Anthony Bank, just because if we get like 30 million, and you push a building halfway, you wait and clear that, and then go back and get like 40 million, roof the building. That's how we manage to make the school grow up to this level.
Okay. So tell us about loan management. For many people, loans are something that you shouldn't indulge yourself in, because many a times they go against you. I mean, you acquire for a loan and probably you fail to pay it back. So how have you managed to work around loans?
No, the problem with the people with loans, people always taken up by money. When they see the money, they go in too many things. They divert the money from the actual target. But I think any businessman, when you borrow and you stick that money to the target, you can't go wrong. Because the moment you apply some money on the institution, the parents will come and see there is a change. The following time you see an enrollment coming up, and you're able to pay the loan. You can't fail to pay the loan unless you divert it.